Not getting a thing.
Getting up for Christmas.
Not getting a thing.
Getting up for Christmas.
Not getting a thing.
Getting up for Christmas.
For
getting up this Christmas Eve.
Well, Johnny is a little brat.
I'm gonna tan his hide.
Well, to darn your run, our pussy cat.
I'm gonna tan his hide.
For the cat could shift her gears. Johnny grabbed the pink and shears, cut off her tail behind her ears.
I'm gonna tan his hide. He's getting nothing for Christmas. He's getting nothing, you bet. Nothing's too good for our Johnny, and that's what he's gonna get.
Once I took him out to dine,
I'm gonna tan his hide.
His table manners were a crime.
I'm gonna tan his hide.
Mashing taters with his toes, pouring gravy on my clothes, shoving string beans up my nose.
I'm gonna tan his hide. He's getting nothing for Christmas. He's getting nothing, you bet. Nothing's too good for our Johnny, and that's what he's gonna get.
He's not getting a thing.
Getting nothing for Christmas.
He's not getting a thing.
Getting nothing for Christmas.
He's not getting a thing.
Getting nothing for Christmas.
Not getting
nothing
thing
this Christmas Eve.
I said, Johnny, on my knee,
I'm gonna tan his hide.
When I told him about the birds and bees,
I'm gonna tan his hide.
That's one talk I ain't forgot. My face was red, my ears were hot. Friends ashore did learn a lot.
I'm gonna tan his hide.
He's getting nothing
for Christmas.
I hope you don't.
He's getting nothing. You bet.
He don't deserve a thing.
Nothing's too good for our Johnny, and that's what he's gonna get.
Frosty the snowman got a job out on the farm, and the farmer knew he'd never do the animals any harm. Frosty had a little lamb and he put it on the shelf, and every time it wagged its tail it spanked its little self. They sent him out to shovel snow and Frosty looked so grim, for every time he stopped to rest, his work piled up on him. Frosty the snowman liked to herd the sheep, it's true. Every day he'd hear the rams a-singing, you, you, you. Frosty tried to milk the cows, but he was such a slouch. The cows would never holler moo, they'd only holler ouch. He fed the cows some sugar, and they drank from a frozen stream. Now when old Frosty milks the cows, they only give ice cream. He crossed red beets and taters, and imagine his surprise. When he dug the taters up, they all had bloodshot eyes. Frosty the snowman backed into the stove one day. Though it felt so warm, it ruined his form. He melted plumb away. I saw Mommy smooching Santa Claus underneath the Christmas tree last night. She puckered up her lips, pleasure she did seek. She missed his mouth and kissed his nose, and the darn thing sprung a leak. Then I heard Mommy tell old Santa Claus, Santa, you're a funny fat old flirt, and you learn to kiss, no doubt, playing bugle in the Boy Scouts. Santa baby, are you sure you ain't all hurt? I saw Mommy smooching Santa Claus underneath the Christmas tree last night. Their smooching was so loud, it woke up Uncle Fudd. It sounded like a cow a-pullin' her foot out of mud. Then I shot Santa with a BB gun, and you should have heard old Santa squall. Well, he jumped about 10 feet, then he took off up the street, and he hollered, Merry Christmas to you all.
Well, who wore long hair and a fuzzy beard before any hippie was ever here? From patent leather boots and psychedelic clothes and little granny glasses upon his nose.
Santa Claus, the original hippie.
Cycle gangs with white leather belts, the funny looking caps, their prides would melt. If they could take a look at Santa Claus, he's buckled, his belly's called pot, that's why he can chuckle.
Santa Claus, the original hippie. Who is the guy who could always fly long before the Wright brothers learned to cry? He's been taking trips since 1583, and he can take a trip without LSD.
Who wears a collar and cuffs of fur? For all we know, there's beads under there. 'Cause he was the first to smell hippie clothes, that's why his fingers up against his nose.
Santa Claus, the original hippie. He's been taking trips since 1583, and he can take a trip without LSD.
Who wears a collar and cuffs of fur? For all we know, there's beads under there. cause he was the first to smell hippie clothes. That's why his fingers up against his nose.
Santa Claus, the original hippie.
Hip, 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 hippie.
All I want for Christmas is my upper plate. I'm losing weight without my plate. I got my lowers, but I need my upper plate so I can eat my Christmas turkey. I left them in a glass of water by my side. When I awoke, I nearly died. I hope the guy who took them will be satisfied, cause I can't eat my Christmas turkey.
I used to eat corn on the cob and little bitty pickle green tomatoes. Christmas Day, all I can say is pass the mashed potatoes.
So won't somebody tell me what I'm gonna do? My poor old gums are black and blue. The turkey's on the table, but I just can't chew. And this ain't a very Merry Christmas.
I can't even chew it just a little. Christmas Day, all I can say is pass the peanut brutal.
Well, that's brittle.
Well, Jethro,
uh-huh.
Without my upper plate, it's brutal.
So if you got an extra plate that's laid away, I'll borrow it for Christmas Day. You can send it to me, care of RCA.
And friends, that address is 806 17th Avenue South, Nashville, Tennessee. I don't know the zip code.
And
I'll have a very Merry Christmas, cha-cha-cha.
Well, I've got a gal, she's 6'3". She's built like a Christmas tree. She's got ornaments. Ornaments.
Yes, you ought to see what she has got for ornaments.
Well, she sent me to the store to get a loaf of bread. I come home with butter and she hit me in the head with those
ornaments. Ornaments. Yes, you ought to see what she has got for ornaments.
She got that shape. She said some doc had used lots of tape on those ornaments.
Ornaments. Yes, you ought to see what she has got for ornaments.
Now Jethro really is so meek. She slapped him when he tried to peek at those ornaments.
Ornaments. Yes, you ought to see what she has got for ornaments.
And when she walks, it's plain to see. It rattles my rattle, my rattle, my tree with those ornaments.
Ornaments. Yes, you ought to see what she has got for ornaments.
Well, before you think them nasty things, her ornaments are those swinging earrings. That's her ornaments.
Ornaments. Yes, you ought to see what she has got for ornaments.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the pad, we were all sacked out, especially old Dad. He came floating in at a quarter past four, and he passed out cold on the living room floor. The children were sleeping as if they were dead. We had slipped them a Mickey and put them to bed. While stuffing the turkey, from Mother we heard, "Hold still or I'll kill you, you dirty old bird." The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, and oh, what a terrible smell filled the air. When all of a sudden the door opened wide, and a fat old cat came a-walking inside. With a beard like a hippie and a crazy red suit, and a sack on his back filled with all kinds of loot. "I'd have come down the chimney," said Jolly St. Nick, "but I just had my suit clean and I gotta look slick. So I'll fill up the stockings and then hurry on, 'cause I left my sleigh in a no parking zone." Well, he brought Ma a new girdle and he said with a smile, "Well, Ma, I guess that ought to hold you a while. And Pa, you'll get a present, you'll get it as soon as I find out just how you gift wrap a saloon. And for all the kiddies, you'll love what I found. It's a rock and roll record without any sound." Then Santa said, "Folks, that's about it. I got places to go, so I gotta split. But I sure am weary from toting this load, so before I go, I'll have one for the road." So we broke out the booze and we all had a blast, and the next thing we knew, old Santa was gassed. Then Santa said, "Folks, I'll just stay here, I think, 'cause I can't drive them reindeer whenever I drink. So let's have another, a shot and a beer, and have a Yule that's cool and a crazy New Year."
Every day, jingle bells, jingle bells, they have got to go. They're okay if you're a penguin or an Eskimo.
Christmas time is here again, with it comes the snow. It's awful hard to start your car when it's 12 below. My antifreeze is failing me, the battery is dead. Then all at once that awful sound comes ringing in my head.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, ringing in my head. If I had a lick of sense, I'd go right back to bed. Jingle bells, jingle bells, listen to them chime. I wish they would have Christmas in the good old summertime.
Shovel off the sidewalk and you shuffle off your car. You don't care where you're going, just as long as it is far. You want to leave this ice and snow, you're ready for the drive. When a city snowplow comes along and buries you alive.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to freeze your feet off every day. Jingle bells, jingle bells, they have got to go. They're okay if you're a penguin or an Eskimo.
Randolph the flat-nosed reindeer had a funny-looking snout. So Santa cut his nose off just to try and smooth it out. And when they sewed his nose on, Sammy sewed it upside down. Now every time the rain falls, poor old Randy nearly drowns. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Randolph, with your nose so flat, won't you tell me where I'm at? Then Randy took a deep breath, and he looked so very strange. We're out behind the stockyards, I wish the wind would change. Randy tried to hitch a ride one cold December day. He jumped on the back of a Chevrolet and the backfire took his breath away. Randolph the flat-nosed reindeer wished his nose would glow instead, but it would never light up 'cause his batteries were dead. Randolph the flat-nosed reindeer.
I need a milking pail for my cow and hound. I use my shoes up till now.
Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby,
the pig house sort of needs a new roof. It's smell proof, so make sure you don't goof.
Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. My poor hen needs a bed. She stays up all night, and gee, I'll bet that she's dead. Maybe she would lay more eggs if she could sort of rest her legs.
Santa baby, my goat needs lots of feed, heaven knows, just so. He'll stop eating my clothes.
Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight.
Santa baby, I need a brand new guitar pick, I vow. I've used my toenail up till now.
Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight.
Santa baby, I need a brand new hunting jacket, so there, you know I can't go a hunting bear.
Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Don't bring me no little shoat, and don't bring me no billy goat. The neighbors sure would throw a fit as soon as they got wind of it.
Santa baby, I've been a good boy all year long, don't scold, I brought home everything that I stole.
Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, hurry down the chimney tonight.
Seen the look on Paul when he seen Santa Claus a kissing Ma. He's a moving on, he's a moving on. That mistletoe has got to go, he's a moving on.
You ought to seen old Santa quiver when she slapped him in the face with a reindeer liver. He's a moving on. He's a moving on. Poor old Saint Nick was a looking sick. He's a moving on. Santa Claus looked awful strange when poor old Rudolph got the mange. He's a moving on. He's a moving on. His nose was red, his fur was dead. He's a moving on. Old Saint Nick let out a whine when he sat down on a porcupine. He's a moving on. He's a moving on. He stood real still when he felt the quill. He's a moving on. Santa was a sad old man when he backed into the electric fan. He's a moving on. He's a moving on. That's all, my friend. This is the end. He's a moving on. The baggy Christmas stockings were lying on the floor. The empty Christmas wrappings looked like there'd been a war. The children weren't nestled or snuggled in their beds. They went a belly whopping down the stairs on their sleds. Then Ma tried on her Christmas hat and felt just like a queen. Till Pa found out how much it cost and turned all red and green. The Christmas tree was lit up and so was Uncle Si. He thought he was a reindeer and insisted he could fly. He hollered out, "Hey Blitzen, why don't you wait for me?" Then landed right smack in the middle of the Christmas tree. Uncle Harry was parading up and down the hall, a-breaking in new slippers, a half a size too small. My sister and her boyfriend were fighting toe-to-toe. She caught him a-kissing someone else beneath the mistletoe. Then Paul got out his squirrel gun, the one he got from Ma. Now he was only cleaning it, but blasted down the wall. The baby started crying, and Ma said, "Can't you see? Christmas comes but once a year, and that's enough for me." And then from in the fireplace there rose up such a clatter. We ran into the parlor to see what was the matter. The chimney was a-shaking, the soot fell all about. A voice within was bellerin', "Won't someone let me out?" We looked upon the rooftop, and much to our surprise, we saw eight little reindeer, but no one there to cry. Then Paul poked up the chimney, he used a great big stick, and all at once came tumbling down a feller called Saint Nick. All covered up with ashes from his head right to his foot, and when he spoke from out his beard fell 20 pounds of soot. "Since Christmas Eve I've been in there, I'd like to make it clear, if you don't get your chimney fixed, I won't be back next year." And then as quick as lightning, he sprang up to his sleigh. He gave a little whistle and soon was on his way. But I could hear him holler as he drove out of sight, "A Merry Christmas to you all, and to you all, good night."